stop for a moment and hydrate again and turn it over to you while you drink or something. I thought I saw him. Yeah, there you go.
Okay. Which was your favorite Vampire Academy book to write?
My favorite Vampire Academy book to write? I would say Shadow Kiss was my favorite. It has the biggest emotional ending. And I know a lot of people say that's a cruel book. I got a lot of hate mail from it. I still do every once in a while. It's kind of funny because to me that book is so ancient history. And then every once in a while, you know, there's some new reader comes along starting the series and they get to it and it's like all brand new for them. And I get an angry email about how I'm terrible and how could I do that. I don't enjoy people suffering or crying at the end of a book. But as an author, you want people to feel something. And while I'm sad you feel bad, I would rather people feel bad than just walk away from a book and have no reaction at all. And for me, you know, that was I hate to say
it was you.
I don't want to say fun exactly, but it was very rewarding to just do something that deep and that hard. And if you want, I can segue into Fiery Heart a little bit now, because I have a similar reaction to that. I'll give you my no, I shouldn't say that. I'll give you my pitch about Fiery Heart. So that comes out, that's book 4 in the Bloodline series. That will be out in November 19th. Mark your calendars. And that is probably, if you had asked me my favorite book in the Bloodline series, I would have said that one is right now. And I really love this book. And you probably think I say that about all my books, and I don't. Actually, I'd say about 2/3 of the time after I finish a book, I send my agent a letter about how it was terrible and how my career is over. And it's always kind of a variation of the same letter, you know? It's like, well, we've had a good run. You know? It's all over now. And I think he's got, like, the same letter, like, saved, and he just changes some of the words and sends it back to me, you know? And it's like, no, Richelle, it's a good book, it's a good book. But I don't always have a lot of confidence when I finish the books. But Fiery Heart, I think it's got just such a huge emotional impact. And the romance is a big part of it, of course. I mean, it's really taken to the next level for those who thought Indigo Spell was hot. Wait till you get to this one. But there is just this very, very dark emotional component to it. We kind of deal with what it means to really be a spirit user. Throughout both series, the term crazy is tossed around a lot. And that's a term I think we use callously in real life. And the book kind of delves into what does that mean to be mentally unstable, to be depressed. And that's kind of a dark journey Adrian's on that Sydney helps him through. And so I think you'll flip around in the book a lot. There are going to be moments, you know, where you're going to just be like, oh, Adrian, you know, and then other times, oh, Adrian. You're all over the place, you know. It's those dueling things, those contradictory things. And the ending's a big gut punch. I don't think you'll be in tears like Shadow Kiss, but it's definitely it's big. And I've been telling people that Fiery Heart to me is kind of what Shadow Kiss and Blood Promise were, you know, in the other series, just in the whoa, this series just got real kind of a way. So.